All right, shalom. Most High in Christ bless.
Most
High in Christ bless. I'm Officer Isaiah. I'm your host to my right.
Officer Ethan.
Officer Noah.
Officer Maccabees.
To my left.
Officer Michael.
Officer Isaiah.
Officer Jalil.
And this is the first episode of Return of the Gods.
Yeah.
All right, check. Yo. Let's get the first slide, man. Let's get the opening thumbnail. First one. All right, there go the title. The agenda. They got Tyson and Denzel. Damn,
not Denzel, man.
Bruh. We got your boy. You idolized him.
It couldn't have been me.
That's the equalizer?
He the equalizer.
They got the equalizer.
Not no more.
Hey, bro, come on now.
They got the equalizer, bro.
Come on, man.
Hey, what's your favorite Denzel movie?
Hey, bro. Man, come on now.
It's over, bro. It's over.
Nah. Come on, man.
Not Training Day. It's
over.
I ain't
gonna say Training Day. That is my favorite.
That is, bro.
It was.
You got trained by the equalizer?
Damn.
I got neutralized.
Bruh.
And this show is already getting a good start.
All right.
Let's get to the top.
All right, let's go to the next slide, man. All right, Return of the Gods, the podcast name and why. So why did we choose the name Return of the Gods? Hey, give me John. John chapter 10 and verse 34. People want to know why. Why we chose Return of the Gods as the name of the show. And they want to know why. Read that.
The book of John, chapter 10 and verse 34. Come on. Jesus answered them.
Jesus what?
Jesus answered them.
So Jesus speaking, go ahead.
Is it not written in your law? I said, ye are gods.
God said what?
Ye are gods.
That's why we named the show Return of the Gods, because we didn't know that we was gods before. But once we opened up the scriptures and got the understanding, we read that we was gods. You see that? Why did we choose that name? Because Christ said it. Read it again.
Jesus answered them, is it not written in your law? I said, ye are gods.
You see that? Now, get Psalms 82 and 6.
The book of Psalms, chapter 82. And verse 6.
Come on.
I have said, ye are gods.
Come on.
And all of you are children of the Most High.
See, we're children of God, so guess what? We gods. It is what it is. So, yeah. No, but everybody can't say they're a child of God. You know what I'm saying? That's what they say in Christianity. They can't say that. You know what I'm saying? Only we can say that. We the gods. And we returning. That's why so much destruction going on the earth. Y'all got anything y'all want to say on that? Anybody got anything they want to say on that?
Hey, man, we the gods, man. We are the gods.
That's right. Hey, you know, we've been taught that we was everything but that. You understand what I'm saying? You tell somebody that they a god, they don't want to hear that. You know what I'm saying? When we tell our brothers they gods, they don't want to hear that. They'd rather be niggas. They'd rather be thugs. They'd rather be rappers. NBA players, but we've been so conditioned and so programmed to thinking of ourselves as everything but a god. You understand? And it was through Christianity, right? So we bringing the scriptures back to life. We showing our people our history. We showing our people what we went wrong at, and we got to return to our true estate, which is the gods of the earth.
Right. Give me that. Stay right there. Jump up to verse 5. Read that.
Verse 5. They know not, neither will they understand. They walk on in darkness.
They what?
They walk on in darkness.
Our people in darkness. We was once in darkness. Go ahead.
All the foundations of the earth are out of course.
And that's why our people don't know that we are gods. You understand what I'm saying? That's why our people don't know that we are the gods of the earth. guess what? We return it to our nationality and our heritage. So hence, we are the return of the gods. All right? You got something you want to say on that?
Return of the gods, you know, that's a... some people might think that's boastful. How y'all Negroes call y'allself guys? You know, they used to us calling ourselves niggas.
Right.
Bloods, Crips, on four now. You know, they comfortable when we call ourselves that. You know, that nigga, that B. But when we call us ourselves gods, you know, they get the screw face.
The whole world in the uproar.
Yeah. You know who else get mad? Who? The black woman.
Oh.
Who was created in the image of the gods.
Black women do get mad. She get mad. But we don't. A god don't give a damn.
Dude. That's it. It's a black woman mad right now. She say these niggas, government assisted, welfare, Section 8 babies think they the sons of God.
How they say they got?
How is this possible? Give me that in 1 Corinthians 1. You know, the base things of the earth. 1 Corinthians 1. Let's see what the Lord say, because this the return of the gods. The Bible's going to tell you where the gods going to come from. Or the gods going to come out of the Ivy League schools? Or is the gods going to come out of the White House? Huh? Let's see where the gods going to come from. Come on.
1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 27.
Come on.
But God hath chosen the foolish things of the world.
You see that? That's right. We was foolish. Used to be in gangs. We used to gang bang. Baby mama, baby father, but guess what? We changed with the word of God. We was foolish. Come on.
To confound the wise.
You see that? The ones you think God. We going to confound who you think Superman is. We going to confound who you think X-Men is.
Right.
They ain't got no real powers. That's all make-believe. We got the power. Finish it.
And God hath chosen the weak things of the world.
Come on.
To confound the things which are mighty.
You see that? God gonna choose the weak things. You right. That's right. We ain't got no military. We ain't got no guns. We don't got nuclear power. We don't got financial banks. But guess what? God still gonna choose us to confound this world. That was it on that, right?
Nope. And base things of the world.
Come on.
And things which are despised.
You see that? I told you the black woman, man. The Lord said things despised. That was it?
Nope. Hath God chosen. Yea, and things which are not, to bring to naught things that are.
You see that? Because it's not her. You don't see it. You don't see my spiritual power right now. Hold on. Look at this. Man. Don't play.
Hey, read that part again where it say the despised.
And base things of the world and things which are despised.
Read.
Hath God chosen.
You see, who the most despised person on the earth? It's the black man.
Black man.
You know what I'm saying? So the Bible plain. You know what I'm saying? It's plain who the Lord chose to confound the earth, to confound the so-called gods of the earth, the make-believe gods of the earth. You understand what I'm saying? That's it.
All right, now go back to Psalms 82 and 6, because we're going to go right into the next segment. All right, read that again.
Psalms chapter 82 and verse 6. I have said, ye are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High.
Come on.
But ye shall die like men.
We going to what?
Ye shall die like men.
Well, we going to die like men. And we finna find out one of the key reasons, or some of the key reasons we die like men today. Now, go to the next topic. What the hell is this? They got Tyson and Denzel in the same week.
You mean one of the greatest boxers.
Bruh.
One of the greatest actors that our people thought was held at a high esteem. They got him.
They got him, man.
That's crazy, man. Hey, man, Mike Tyson was knocking cats out. You know what I'm saying? He's one of the greatest boxers. You mean to tell me they got him?
Couldn't have been me.
Damn. But we gonna touch on it a little bit. Let's deal with, let me see, man. We got to play. We're going to deal with Denzel first. All right, let's read that. Somebody read that.
Let me read that. I got you.
Denzel Washington film gay kissing scene for Gladiator 2. But chicken filmmakers cut it.
Denzel filmed gay kissing scene for Gladiator 2. Come on, man. We got to read the article, man. We got to, you know what I'm saying? We got to see what's going on here.
Gladiator 2 nearly had it all. Epic battle scenes, heavy doses of nostalgia, emotional monologues, and even an unexpected gay kiss.
Damn.
Bruh.
Why did they say it was unexpected? You understand what I'm saying? Why did they say it was unexpected? Come on.
Until filmmakers cut the ladder. Denzel Washington.
The ladder meaning the kiss. Wait.
Denzel Washington revealed in an interview with Gayety that his kissing...
Whoa.
Yo, what's going on?
This That's is, a word, Gayety.
This is all kind of... All kind of moist verbiage right here, man. I don't know what's going on. This is
diabolical.
This is real fluffy right now, but go ahead.
Bruh.
That his kissing scene with another male actor was not included in the final edit of the movie, which hits theaters on November 22nd.
Now, when I seen the video, right, when him of him confessing, this confessing, you know what I'm saying, what he about, you know what I'm saying? You know, the question wasn't even asked. Like, he just stood it, just freely gave the information like it was, you know, like he wanted the world to know.
Hey, bro, come on now,
you know what I'm saying? Yo, I like Denzel movies,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, he had to speak his truth.
Yeah, he was speaking his truth, man.
That's crazy, man.
I like Denzel, man. I felt a way about this, man.
Bruh.
A lot of people did.
We
honestly.
All did, bro. We all
hey,
did.
Bro, come on now.
A lot of people, all black people love Denzel Washington. Black people post Denzel Washington memes. They know, they recite his movies. Everybody try to impersonate Denzel Washington, so a lot of black people was hurt by that.
Bro. I can't use no more Denzel memes.
That's
bro.
Crazy. Oh, they banned. Banned.
The hell is this?
Right. That was our superhero.
Yeah.
You know how they got X-Men and Superman?
Right.
You know, them was our superheroes. You know, that's gone now.
Hey, it's over, bro.
For real. What was Hancock? Or that was Will. That guy Will Smith.
Nah, I ain't mess with Hancock like that.
Yeah. You ain't like Hancock?
Bruh.
What like brother? Will Smith.
Will Smith forward, bro.
I Am Legend.
I Am Legend was good.
I Robot, you know.
Yeah, that was good.
Now we can't look at him the same because, you know, he did a Denzel.
The question is, why?
That is true.
That's
why?
A good question. That's a good question.
Why now?
But let's keep reading. Let's read a little bit more. Since he wanted to offer this to the world, offer this information to the world.
I actually kissed the man in the film, but they took it. They cut it. I think they got chicken.
Hey, yo.
Bruh.
Chicken. Man,
come on.
Hey, bro. Come on now, dog.
What do you mean by
damn,
that?
Damn.
Come on, man.
You want to know, he really thought they was going to put that in the film. Since everybody is into this LGBT stuff, he probably thought, hey, we're going to wear this.
Damn.
Yeah, play the video. Let's just play it.
It sounded like he was hurt. That they didn't put it in the movie.
He looked frustrated.
Yeah.
Play that video I posted. Last one in there.
Soon as he dropped that, you know, I mean, that little gay kiss that he did, he announced.
Now he's the Black Panther.
He's
the new Black Panther.
Yeah, he's going to be in the Black Panther.
He said he about to be done making films.
Yeah.
He said, and this next couple movies going to be the end of his legacy and things he want to be remembered for. Things he ain't done before.
Damn.
Yeah. Bruh.
Sick.
Yeah, bossy boy now.
Damn. He said in the mic, bro.
Bruh.
He better do something strange for a piece of change.
Damn.
Bruh.
Y'all got the video?
All right, play it.
I actually kissed a man in the film, but they took it. They cut it.
Pause it right there.
That chicken.
Look how excited go back, she was go when back. He said that.
Like, pause it after right at where Rainey starts saying it. Pause it on her face.
I actually kissed a man in the film, but they took it.
She looked like she's surprised he said that. But ain't no coincidence that rainbow in the background.
That's what I'm saying.
I think she might be, you know what I'm saying, but who gives a damn?
That was excitement. That was an expression of excitement. She was,
right.
She was excited about
right.
that.
He was like, well, let me say.
He was being interviewed by, it was a setup in the first place. Because the brother on her, Denzel, he doing the interview with a damn Transformer.
That's a tranny?
Yeah, that's
the
dude.
Lord have mercy.
That's the LGBTQ monster that he got on set with.
Yeah, I thought that was a girl.
Bro, come on now, dog.
I mean, I don't know what it was. It's a pronoun. It was he did the interview with a pronoun.
Whoa.
So it wasn't no surprise that he said what he said.
This,
come on, man.
This wasn't no. This was this interview was done on purpose. She knew he was gonna say that. It was already set up from the jump with the rainbow. It's a man dressed like a woman.
Right. Hey man, give me Job, man. Get Job 9:24. Get Job 9:24.
The book of Job, chapter 9 and verse 24.
Come on.
The earth is given into the hand of the wicked.
Listen, Esau the devil, Satan is ruling this world. You understand? Satan is ruling this world. He's ruling the entertainment business. You understand what I'm saying? And guess what? We're going to find out everybody in entertainment gay as hell.
Damn.
You understand what I'm saying? They getting their trunk popped out here.
Everybody.
You understand what I'm saying? All That's the greatest. Latest and greatest. You understand?
Can I get a scripture on that?
Go ahead.
Hey, get Isaiah 3 and 9. Because I know we talking about the man, right? That's a man. That was a man. We talked about the tranny and how great they happy they looked to see that Denzel did such a thing. They was happy to see that he joined their side. Watch this, read. But let's talk about Denzel.
Isaiah chapter 3 and verse 9.
Uh-huh.
The show of their countenance doth witness against them.
Because Denzel said, they was chicken to put it in. I was happy to do it. I'm like, yo, that's why everybody was so shocked. We love Denzel. We would never think he'd do something like that. But Denzel didn't have no shame in his game about it. Read it again.
The show of their countenance doth witness against them.
Read.
And they declare their sin as Sodom.
Uh-huh.
They hide it not.
Denzel didn't want to hide. He didn't hide that thing at all. That's how shameful he was. He didn't have no shame. He thought that thing was all right to do. He wanted it. He was mad they cut it out the movie.
Bruh.
They could have. Now look.
And he wanted it to be a shining moment.
Denzel could have. Now we know it's evil, whether it was on the whether it showed on the movie or wasn't on the movie. But he could have just went about it and nobody would have ever knew. But
I mean, he did it. He wasn't asked to do it.
Exactly.
Nah, it was going to come out. It was going to come out. But this the same man that said he don't want to do no movies kissing no white women. He said that because he respect his sisters too much.
I bet it was a white man he kissed in his movie.
You know damn well it was.
Not a white woman. He wanted to kiss a white man.
That's crazy.
So he was saying that he ain't going to kiss no white women. You know what I'm saying? But white men not off limits.
That's wild.
Damn.
Hey, play that video I just put in there. That last one. Play that, man. This is going to tell you what this is going to give you the climate of society today.
The Matrix is a system, Neo.
Right, my only man.
That system is full of degenerates. When you're inside, you look around, what do you see? Businessmen, teachers, lawyers, carpenters, the very minds of the people we are trying to save. But until we do, these people are still a part of the woke system, and that makes them our enemy. You have to understand, most of these people are not ready to pick up a biology textbook. And many of them are so inert, so hopelessly dependent on their pronouns that they will fight to protect it. Were you listening to me, Neo? Or were you looking at the dude in the red dress?
A dude?
Look again. Who is it?
That's crazy.
It's another training program designed to teach you one thing. If you are not one of us, you might marry one of them.
What are they?
Transformers. They can move in and out of any gender, regardless of their chromosomes. That means that anyone coming out of the female bathroom is potentially a ladyboy. Inside the Matrix, they can identify as anything, but in reality, it's just delusion.
Bruh.
We have survived by hiding from them, by running from them. But they are at the Diddy parties. They are guarding all the doors while they are touching all the kids, which means that sooner or later, someone is going to have to fight them.
Someone.
I won't lie to you, Neo. Every single man or woman who has stood their ground, everyone who has fought this agenda, got canceled. But where they have failed, you will succeed.
What?
I've seen an agent identify as a concrete wall. Men have emptied entire clips at them and hit nothing but air. Yet their strength and their speed are still based in a world that is built on rules. Because of that, they will never be as strong or as fast as you can be.
What are you trying to tell me? that I can dodge lawsuits?
No, Neo. If you identify as an innocent human being, you won't have to.
I identify as an innocent human being.
So that's the, that's the climate we living in today. Read that in Job again. What is God telling us? Job 9:24, man.
The book of Job, chapter 9 and verse 24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked.
God telling us we surrounded by Autobots and Decepticons, Transformers. That's what he's saying. You understand what I'm saying? Bruh. This place is wicked. Nothing is as it seems. Eventually, everything's coming out. People are getting, brothers is out here getting their trunk popped. You understand what I'm saying? Denzel, damn near 70. Damn near 70. And now you want to kiss a man.
Bro, it's over, bro.
Get that Ciroc. Ciroc 10, verse 9. Listen, man. Black folks want to ignore this word of God like it ain't true. The Lord gonna make it all true. He gonna put it in front of your face where you can't deny it. Come on, read that.
Ciroc chapter 10 and verse 9.
Come on.
Why is earth and ashes proud? There is not a more wicked thing than a covetous man.
What kind of man?
A covetous man.
Read.
For such an one setteth his own soul to sail.
Set his what?
His own soul to sail.
All I can see is covetousness with Denzel doing this. You are, to us, esteemed as the greatest black male actor of all time. You understand what I'm saying? You ain't hurting for nothing. You didn't have to do this. You understand? But it had to be something. It had to be something that you wanted that's eluding, that's escaping your grasp. You understand? Read.
Because while he liveth, he casted away his bow.
He casted away what?
His bow.
He bent over, got his lock picked.
Bruh.
Damn.
Hey, bro, come on now, dog.
Can I say something on that?
Go ahead, man.
Hey, get 1 Corinthians 5 and 10.
Damn, Denzel.
That's a hurt edit. Yeah, black people thought it was AI. They said, bro, that's AI.
I thought it was AI.
We thought that was AI at first.
I knew that wasn't real.
We had to get 6 sources to verify. But read that real quick. Just go with the video, the Matrix video, and what you just brought up. So read that.
1 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 10.
Read verse 9.
Verse 9. I wrote unto you in an epistle, not to company with fornicators.
Keep going.
Yet not altogether with the fornicators of this world.
The kissing man is fornication of this world. Read.
Or with the covetous.
Being covetous to kiss a man. Read.
Or extortioners.
Uh-huh.
Or with idolaters.
Keep going.
For then must ye needs go out of the world.
It's like it's all around us, like you were saying in the video. He said they everywhere. They come out the bathrooms. You don't know what you looking at. You got to leave the world just to leave this stuff behind. Otherwise, it's going to corrupt you. If you amongst you in the world like that. It, like you said, Denzel done made, 30 movies. He do plays, movies.
Yeah.
All this stuff, great things he done. And it got to him. You said, what, officer?
He done directed movies?
Yeah, directed movies. Everything. All of now, finally, like you said, at the end of his career, he an old man now. And he decided to conform to the way of this world.
Hey, yo, can I get a script on that?
You got
one. All right, so listen. At one point, Denzel understood his role as a black man. You know what I'm saying? He was a father. He's a husband. You understand what I'm saying? But after a while, he lost grip of that because the earth is given over to the hand of the wicked. All right? And when you are a part of this place, it will defile you. Give me that in Job chapter 32 and verse 9. All right? Because at his age, he should understand that he has a role in the society and to his nation as a people. You understand what I'm saying? But he lost that. But we're here to bring it back to the people.
Right.
Read what you got.
Job chapter 32 and verse 9. Great men are not always wise.
Now, Denzel, he's a great man. He's got a lot of Oscars, all right? Nominated for a lot of awards and things like that. You understand? He made a lot of good movies. But guess what? The scriptures say great men, all right, are not always wise. They do some dumb stuff. Unless you got the Spirit of God in you, you're going to do some things that's off the charts. You understand? Read it again.
Great men are not always wise.
So great men in this world are not always wise. Come on.
Neither do the aged understand judgment.
So guess what? The aged man don't always know what the right thing to do is. You understand? They make wrong decisions. You understand? His role as a black man is to be a good example to his people. But guess what? He destroyed his name, his image, and everything else.
Right. Just the profession of an actor is he's a professional liar.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? Like, he lied about being a God-fearing man. You understand Christian. What I'm saying? You got something?
I got something. Let me get Romans 12 and 2. Because, you know, we're hearing all this stuff. We're seeing all this stuff. And if you're not in this Bible, you wouldn't want to believe it. Read that real quick.
Romans chapter 12 and verse 2. And be not conformed to this world.
Right. The Bible says, be not conformed to this world. Go ahead.
But be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind.
Why is that? Why? Because we seeing all this evil going on, right? Like, you would think that video was AI. You would say, nah, not Denzel. But then you got to read the scripture. It say, hey, be not conformed to this world. Why? Because this world is given to the hand of the wicked. Esau is turning everybody into Bozzy Boys. With Denzel. It's hard to believe, but the scriptures say you cannot be conformed to this world. Why? Because you will accept that.
What was positive about him admitting that he kissed a man? How was black folks going to progress in this society by him mentioning that?
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? When he said that thing, that was a detriment to our people.
Yeah, man.
Millions of young men looked up to him.
And the crazy thing about it is, when he said that, and like you had mentioned earlier, he said that, and guess what? All of Hollywood, all black people, all these comedians, all these actors, they silent right now.
Damn.
Because he was esteemed as an idol to a lot of our people.
Yeah.
Because, give me that in Sirach 4 and 22. Watch this. Because a lot of time when it comes to black people, you know, certain people can't do no wrong in their eyes.
Right.
Certain people just can't do no wrong. Like, we going over Tyson and Denzel right now. These was two black men for the longest that couldn't do no wrong in the black community's eyes.
No, not Tyson.
But you know, Tyson.
Yeah. Tyson, wow.
But guess what? But everybody, Tyson though.
After
bit a nigga ear off.
I'm with you.
He bit a nigga ear off.
Damn.
So watch this. Sirach 4 and 22. Read that.
Sirach chapter 4 and verse 22.
Read.
Accept no person against thy soul.
So the Lord said, accept no person against your soul. This is when it goes into making people idols, your idols, because God says one thing. God is clearly against homosexuality.
Facts.
He went on TV and admitted that he kissed another man in the mouth.
Facts.
So you still associating yourself with Denzel and not speaking against it, you accepting that person against your soul. But read on.
Accept no person against thy soul.
Uh-huh.
And let not the reverence of any man cause thee to fall.
And let not the reverence of any man cause thee to fall. These are people that the black community hold in high esteem. But what the Lord is showing our people right now, that all these people that are set up of the world, they are evil. They wicked as hell. It ain't no cleanness that's out here in this world outside of this truth. So the Lord is revealing all that wickedness. Even with our brother Denzel. Lord's will he repent, but guess what? He is not the leaders for our people to be following.
Hey, yo, Officer Maccabees, what's the name of that other actor that they just got on? That played on Lovecraft Country.
Jonathan Majors.
You understand? So first it was Jonathan Majors, right? And now it's Denzel Washington.
Yeah.
They come for the great. You understand? And it's important. Give me Romans chapter 8 and verse 19, right? It's important that somebody talks about these things and bring them to light, because it's a void in the earth. You understand what I'm saying? The Bible calls this the place of darkness. You understand? We live in inhabited desolate places. So this is the thing that has to happen. Read what you got.
Romans chapter 8 and verse 19.
Come on.
For the earnest expectation of the creature waiteth for the manifestation of the sons of God.
So guess what? The manifestation of the sons of God is here. The sons of God is going to talk about these topics. We're going to go into the book of our fathers,
right?
The Son of God. We're going to talk about the Son of God and shed light on what's going on in the earth. All
Return
right?
to God.
Because guess what God said? Get that in Proverbs chapter 12 and verse 26. It don't matter how much you claim to be Christian, how much you feel like you're an upstanding man. God says he weighs actions. And when you in a certain condition, guess what you're going to turn out? Come on, read this. Read that.
Proverbs 12:26. Chapter 12 and verse 26.
Come on.
The righteous is more excellent than his neighbor.
Come on.
But the way of the wicked.
The what?
The way of the wicked.
Read.
Seduceth them.
No matter. It don't matter who you are, what you got. As long as you around the wicked, you're going to be seduced. It don't matter how strong you are. Right. You understand what I'm saying? It's going. You're going to succumb to it.
Right.
So at this point, all the way up to, like, what, he's 69 now, 70?
Yeah.
We thought he was upstanding. You understand? He stood strong a long time.
You know, hey, what's crazy,
he
man?
He got his lockpick, man.
He probably going to go to church next Sunday. The pastor ain't going to say nothing about that kiss. Give me Psalms 94, right. Verse 16. That's why the Israelites, we here today, we going to speak against it. Why? Because it's a sin according to God. But the pastor ain't going to say nothing. Denzel going to go to church probably and give his offering. The pastor going to say Jesus still loves you. Read that.
Psalms chapter 94 and verse 16.
Go ahead.
Who will rise up for me?
The Lord say, who going to rise up for him? Go ahead.
Against the evildoers.
Against the evildoers. Go ahead.
Or who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity?
Why? Because the whole world is against God. So it's up to the Israelites to teach God's laws. And guess what we're going to do? We're going to say what he's doing is wrong. You understand? We're going to show the world, according to God, that kissing another man oh man, that is a sin according to God. He need to repent.
Can I say something?
It's crazy.
To back up, the lamb back on both of y'all points, right? Give me Luke chapter 16 and 15, all right? Because we got to show the people that, you know what, kissing a man is wrong, all right? When you look at his interview, he said, oh, it's Gladiator. You know what I'm saying? He's trying to support the
right.
Roman.
Right, right. It's okay. It's Gladiator. Okay.
It's Gladiator. It's Gladiator. It's just acting. It's just a movie. Read what you got.
Luke chapter 16 and verse 15.
Come on.
And he said unto them, ye are they which justify yourselves before men.
So now when you look at the interview, right, he's trying to justify what he did by being acting, by the genre of the movie. You understand? That's him justifying himself among men, why he did what he did, trying to uphold his image still. But no, that's gay. Read.
But God knoweth your hearts.
But what?
But God knoweth your hearts.
So you was asking a question. Why now? It's got to be something. So you succumb to covetousness, right? God know your heart. He know why you did it, Denzel. Read.
For that which is highly esteemed among men.
That thing that's highly esteemed among men, this whole gay agenda and all that, that's highly esteemed among men right now. America is pushing that agenda. Read.
Is abomination in the sight of God.
That's an abomination in the sight of God. And you're going to be right. Judged for that if you don't repent, brother.
That's right. Now give me that in Sirach 13, man.
Let me get that law.
Damn.
Right after this. Get Sirach 13 and 23. Sirach 13 and 23. Come on.
Sirach chapter 13 and verse 23. When a rich man speaketh, every man holdeth his tongue.
You see that? And some people going to let it slide just because it's Denzel. You understand? Go ahead.
And look what he saith. They extol it to the clouds.
They going to extol what he say to the clouds. Because he said what he said, now some brothers that might have been on the fence, guess what they going to do? Now they going to be like, well, you know what? I've been having thoughts about it. Right. So now it's okay. Denzel did it. Go ahead.
But if the poor man speak.
And that's us right now. We speaking against that. Go ahead.
They say, what fellow is this?
They looking at us like we crazy because we speaking against what he did. You understand? Go ahead.
And if he stumble, they will help to open.
And that's what black folks do. You understand what I'm saying? When we bringing out what's upright according to God, depending on who it is, they going to come up against us. Go ahead, get that law now.
We can't make no mistakes at all.
Exactly.
They're going to try to comfort us.
But damn.
The rich man, he can slip up at all, any time, and they're going to hold their tongue. They're not going to say nothing. You know what I'm saying? They're going to come to his defense.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Damn. That's crazy.
They're going to talk about all the good stuff he done.
Yeah.
Right.
Right.
And I ain't going to say Denzel probably ain't done some good stuff in his life to help black people. I don't know, but... But
they're gonna try to justify him.
He kissed, exactly.
He
that's
did
what
was selfish
saying.
As
he
hell.
Kissed that damn heathen, man. He did.
That was
damn.
Selfish
he
as
did.
Hell.
Crazy.
He did that.
Get that in Leviticus.
Kiss the German Shepherd.
What God said.
Damn.
Leviticus chapter 18 and verse 22.
Uh-huh.
Thou shalt not lie with mankind. as with womankind. It is abomination.
God said homosexuality is an abomination. We are not to be dealing in that thing. Not even the appearance of it. That's what the scriptures say. Get verse 29 right there in the same chapter.
Verse 29. For whosoever shall commit any of these abominations.
Abomination means it's disgusting in God's eyes. Man kissing man, that's disgusting. We are not to do those things, read.
Even the souls that commit them shall be cut off from among their people.
Because a lot of our people are dealing that lifestyle. And if they don't repent, they're going to get cut off, meaning they're going to die when Christ returns. A lot of our people don't know that. Homosexuality will get you deaf when the Lord returns.
Hey, that's why the scriptures say, don't trust in uncertain riches, right? Because all of, like Officer was saying, it was something he was coveting. But all of these things that our people covet revolves around that American dream. You understand what I'm saying? So when you trust in that, you're gonna start to compromise things. You're gonna start to compromise your morals. You're gonna start to compromise your integrity. You're gonna start to compromise the legacy that you had. You understand what I'm saying? You had a legacy of a masculine man. Like all his roles and even his outside of the acting, he was looked at as a masculine black man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But he just compromised all of that, you know, for the sake of whatever he was coveting. So you just, all these people that was looking up to you, and that's what our people don't understand. We got an answer for that. We got an answer for the souls that look up to us. You understand what I'm saying? That's watching you, right? So,
hey,
that's it.
Can I land back on that real quick? Because that's a perfect segue into the scripture. 2 Maccabees 6 and 24, because it's a difference. You know, these men that America set up for us to be our leaders, to be the male role model for the black man, guess what? All those men, they are corrupt. All of them. Because if they not coming out of the train of thought that they Israelites and they're supposed to be keeping the commandments of God, guess what? They are not the role model that we should be following. Because you see, as our fathers betrayed themselves in 2 Maccabees 6, you read about our father Eleazar. He was an old man. Watch what it says about him. Read that.
2 Maccabees chapter 6 and verse 24.
So he did the opposite of what Denzel did.
For it becometh...
Start at verse 23. Start at verse 23.
Verse 23.
Yes, sir.
But he began to consider discreetly.
So this was our forefather Eleazar. He was in the moment of being tortured, and he was getting ready to be put before all Israel to do a sin, to eat some pork.
Right.
In order to what? To get the nation to follow after him, because they knew he was a leader in the community. So they know he had influence on what other young black men thought. So this is the thought that he had within himself when he was put in that situation to whether he was going to sin and sell out for his people. Read.
And as became his age,
uh-huh,
and the excellency of his ancient years,
uh-huh,
and the honor of his gray head.
Right, so the excellency of his ancient years and the honor of his gray head, meaning what? He lived the honorable life. He was an upstanding role model for the people the whole time that he lived. Read.
Whereunto he was come. And his most honest education from a child.
Read.
Or rather the holy law made and given by God.
Uh-huh.
Therefore he answered accordingly and willed them straightways to send him to the grave.
Right. So he said, look, I'd rather die than stain the honor and legacy that I created my whole life. But read on.
For it becometh not our age, said he. In any wise.
Uh-huh. Read.
To dissemble.
Uh-huh.
Whereby many young persons.
Many what?
Many young persons.
Many what?
Many young persons.
Uh-huh.
Might think that Eleazar, being 80 years old and 10.
So 90 years old, read.
Were now gone to a strange religion.
Right. So he said, I ain't gonna be this old man selling out. I done lived all my years with a spotless, clean image. I'm not going to do this thing and convince other young men to sin because I know that my life matters to other black men. So therefore, I'm going to hold myself to a standard even when faced with death. But that's the opposite of what you got the man that America creates, because even though everybody loves Denzel, Denzel is a product of America, not of God.
All praise.
Go ahead, Austin. Yes, sir. Hey, pull up what I had, the link I had. And go back to the picture with Denzel and the woman. Do that. So pull up that and then have that the Denzel and the woman. I want to point out something here. Get the what the scripture a man may be known in his looks. Watch this, cause this cause I it's ironic to see Denzel. I never seen Denzel with a full shaved head, missing beard and hair. That's uncommon. But we gonna read something, and we gonna see why he did that. It's a deeper meaning behind it, and we gonna the scripture about the Lord said, "What you got? Come on, sir."
Sirach chapter 19 and verse 29. A man may be known by his look, and one that hath understanding by his countenance.
Right, meaning his countenance. When we used to see, we never seen Denzel look like this.
Damn.
Look at him. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
No, his countenance changed.
Yeah, it's crazy. He's real fruity right now.
There you go. We could tell his understanding has changed. Read the scripture one more time.
A man may be known by his look, and one that hath understanding by his countenance, when thou meetest him.
When thou meetest him. Now, this is our first time seeing Denzel look like this. Now, go to what I showed. Go to the link real quick, where we just pulled up, what I put in the Telegram about Denzel.
The last thing you put in there.
Yep, the last thing. All right. Cool. Now, go down. Go down. Scroll down real quick. Keep going all the way down, y'all. So this is about shaving heads. So I have to look at something like, why these people shave their heads? Keep going down. Keep going down. I had it in there. All right. All right. Go back up just a little. Go to stop at sexuality and gender. Go back up. It's going to be in bold letters. Sexuality and gender. Right now there. Watch this. Read this. This is going into shaving heads. Watch this. Read this.
Sexuality and gender. A sexual fetish involving head shaving is called haircut fetishism.
Right, meaning when men shave their head, it's called haircut fetishism. Now read.
While a shaved head on a man is often seen as a sign of authority and virility, a shaved head on a woman typically connotes androgyny.
Meaning she have characteristics of a masculine and feminine energy. Meaning she said, I'm both. That's her expression when she shaved her head. Now watch this. Read this.
Especially when combined with traditionally feminine signifiers.
Right. That's feminine. Now watch this. Read this right here.
Drag queen.
What?
Drag queen.
In the video. Uh-oh. What was in the video? When he, who was interviewing Denzel Washington?
The tranny.
It was a drag queen. So it said drag queens. What?
Have sometimes adopted shaved heads to express a gender queer image.
That's a gender queer image. That's a sign of you expressing a gender queer image.
Damn.
So he's showing that he's in agreement with them. That's he shaved his head and his beard. Finish it. And we're going to read the law. Come on.
And the BDSM community.
Meaning that go into some sexual stuff. BDS, dominatrix, some sexuality. Read.
Shaving a submissive or slave's head is often used to demonstrate powerlessness or submission to the will of a dominant.
There you go. So shaving your head is a sign that you in submission to the will of the dominant. So him shaving his head was showing that he's in agreement. Can we pull up the drag queen one more time with Denzel Washington? He submitted and he's showing that he's in agreement with the agenda that they're pushing. That's why in a video he came out and said, I kissed a man. If it wasn't in a scene, why you feel the need to say it?
Just offered it up there like that.
This was all agenda. This here is a drag queen.
Damn.
Denzel shaved his head and face to show he's in agreement with this agenda.
He in allegiance with it.
Hey, yo, can I say something toward that?
Yes.
All right, so speaking on the agenda, right? Because there is an agenda, right? Check this. All right, so in middle school, I took French, ça passe, right? My French teacher, right, she told us that overseas in Europe and on that side of the earth, sex is not put in movies like that over here. You understand what I'm saying? So when you understand that, you gotta know that there's an agenda on this side of the earth. And what's the agenda? It's that the tribe of Judah will be in the last days on this side of the earth, and they're gonna wake up the nation of Israel.
That's right.
Can I read the scripture?
Go ahead.
Deuteronomy chapter 33 and verse 7. Get that.
So this is the agenda on you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. They exploit our people in Hollywood, have our women half-dressed and have our men doing homosexual things and whatnot, because there's an agenda, all right, to emasculate the black man, the leaders, the true leaders of the earth. Read what you got.
Deuteronomy chapter 33 and verse 7. And this is the blessing of Judah.
So this is the blessings of the tribe of Judah. Come on.
And he said, hear, Lord, the voice of Judah.
So the voice of Judah is going to be heard by the Lord. The Lord is going to use the voice of the so-called black, African-American, right, in the last days for his purpose. Read.
And bring him unto his people.
So he's going to be the one that's going to gather the 12 tribes. Read.
Let his hands be sufficient for him.
So he's going to give him the ability, right? He's going to be given the spirit of God, all right, for to gather his people. Read.
And be thou an help to him from his enemies.
And he's going to make Judah the help against the people that's pushing the agenda. You understand? So that's you know what I'm saying? We got to dig deep sometime.
Right. Now get that next video. Get the next video. Get 000. We got to talk about Tyson.
You gotta say pause when you say gladiator now.
Damn.
Hey.
Iron Mike, man. Tyson.
Hey, officer, damn. Real quick, before we go to Tyson.
Can't say
real,
Iron Mike no
quick.
More either.
With that, the company that did that interview, the company was called Gaiety. So Gaiety, now they using Denzel Washington as they face of their company. And so
is that an article?
It's in there. Because they was already an LGBTQ plus production company. Mm. So it wasn't a coincidence that he said what he said. Like it was all a setup. Matter of fact, it says, can you pull it up real quick? Just pull it up real quick. Yeah, it's in the chat. It's in the bottom. That picture I posted.
And also him shaving his head. Yeah. That was a symbol of him showing that he's in agreement or alignment with them.
Damn.
Go ahead. Read that.
Gaiety, LGBTQ plus stories, queer culture, gay news.
So it's gay news. So that the people that was interviewing was a company for gay news. So it was, he already knew what it was before he even took the interview. Read.
Focusing on uplifting stories about entertainment, pop culture, travel, and health. Gaiety produces LGBTQ plus content that entertains, educates, and inspires joy.
So he went and did.
Yo, what kind of joy are they trying to inspire?
So he did that interview to be gay. Like, that was the whole point.
That was the whole purpose of that interview.
The whole, that's crazy. Hey, he went on her to be gay.
Wow.
Put the thing back on her. They got my man face on the front page of their website. When you look up Gaiety, Denzel Washington face is right there.
Damn.
So instead of being the image of the for the black man, now he's the image of Gaiety. Of LGBTQ plus. And now that's what he has become the face of, instead of being the face for masculine black men.
Hey man, get 1 Corinthians 6 and 9, man. Damn, so bro. Now. So bro. Now. Man. So now. Denzel has crossed over. You understand what I'm saying? He's standing on that side now. Read that.
1 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 9.
So should nobody, no God-fearing man be listening to none of his inspirational quotes? You understand what I'm saying? Because guess what? Denzel's he's a great orator. That's part of the gift that he got. He can talk.
Damn.
He can convince you of anything. You understand? Read that.
Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God.
Now, just because it's Denzel, we need to understand that this man is unrighteous. We read the law. The Lord is against homosexuality and anything and anybody to do with it. Read.
Be not deceived.
God said, don't deceive yourself.
Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers. Nor effeminate.
Nor what?
Nor effeminate.
Nor effeminate or what?
Nor abusers of themselves with mankind.
See, it start off with a kiss. Then it ends up in abuse.
Bruh.
He gonna get his damn trunk popped. You know, he getting his lock picked. You understand what I'm saying?
Come on now, dog.
Getting this lock, Jimmy, man. Go ahead, read.
Bruh.
Northeast.
Yeah, that was crazy. Bruh. Go ahead, read.
Bruh.
Pause.
Bruh.
Northeast.
Come on.
Nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortionists shall inherit the kingdom of God.
So listen, ain't nobody, should nobody be listening to nothing that Denzel got to say inspiring no more. Because he already let everybody know what side he's on. You understand?
Damn.
Let's move on to Tyson, man.
Tyson.
You know what I'm saying? Play that video, man.
Jay, why do you think Mike was so quiet tonight?
He's scared or something. I don't know, but it pisses me off. I guess I'm just used to having to carry the promotions anyway, so it is what it is, but I wish he had that animal. You know?
Pause! He said he wished he had that animal. That's how they look at us. They look at us like an animal. You understand what I'm saying? Play it.
We'll see. I hear you want to fight next after Mike.
We'll see, man.
That's
we'll
all I wanted out of it. Now, get that one mic I put in there. The interview.
I saw the locker room interview with Tyson. It was very intense. Like, you know, you could tell in the locker room, it was just quiet. It was intense. It's like Tyson's about to beat the shit out of Jake Paul. It was just really intense. And then the guy interviews Tyson. Tyson said, yeah, it's on. It's going to be destruction. I'm going to kill him. You know, whatever. Tyson did his thing. But he kisses the guy on the cheek. Boom, boom, boom. Love you. And he walks away. I don't know what this cameraman, I don't know if Tyson set this up. Tyson's like, listen, when I walk away, I want you to show my ass. Show my ass. Show all my butt cheeks, man. I want people to know that my ass is on the line. I know that was corny, but I just had to do it because it made me laugh. So, but what was the ass shot, though? That when I saw it, I was like, whoa. I know it's Netflix, but damn. I was like, yo, what's the ass? You guys saw the locker room interview with Tyson. It was very...
Godfrey
Light. Man, what y'all got to say about that, man?
Godfrey Light. Damn.
Bruh.
It was another video.
You know what's crazy, man? That was on Netflix. They said over 60 million people watched that fight.
Bruh.
Right. It looked like they trying every way possible to push gayism.
Yeah, they pushing that agenda.
On us. Every little small nuance they can get to push gayness on a black community, it seemed like they doing it in every way. Because we don't need to see a man backport.
And you know what? They put that on Netflix.
Damn.
The special on Netflix. Everybody got Netflix at home.
Right.
So they had the fight on Netflix. They said there was so many people watching it that it was freezing up.
Right.
60 million people.
Hey.
Go ahead.
Hey, this goal, what you just was talking about with the shaving the head. Tyson got shaved head, right? Mm-hmm. Now, hey, get 2 Samuel 10:4. Shave heads with buttocks out. That's crazy.
Bruh.
They got the black man. They just, man, that's crazy. That's not a coincidence, bro. Man,
ain't no
that
problem.
Is not a coincidence. Read now that.
How do you believe in God?
Read verse 4.
2 Samuel chapter 10 and verse 4.
Uh-huh.
Wherefore Hanun took David's servants.
So David's servants got kidnapped. Read.
And shaved off the one half of their beards.
What he do to them?
And shaved off the one half of their beards.
Shaved off their beards. Tyson and Denzel. No beard. Read.
And cut off their garments in the middle. Even to their buttocks.
To the what?
Their buttocks.
He said, I want to show the whole world my butt. So they can see.
Man, that was crazy.
But look.
Wow.
That's what the scripture said. This is a sign of shame. Keep reading, though.
And sent them away. When they told it unto David, he sent to meet them, because the men were greatly ashamed.
They was what?
They were greatly ashamed.
It's a shame for you to cut your beard off, shave your head, and have your ass out. You should be ashamed not to show the whole world that. Is that it on that?
And the king said, tarry at Jericho until your beards be grown.
He said, go on, make sure, go on until your stuff grow back, because you look crazy. It was a shame. But now the aged black man, bald head, buttocks out. For millions of people to see.
In the locker room.
In the right. The camera shouldn't even be in there.
Interviewing. Then he kissed
the dude. You know when they say you going bald, shave it all off. Because if you don't do that, that's a sign that you insecure. So you being secure to the world, or what they pushing is, a secure man can shave his head all bald and be comfortable in his own skin. which that goes against the scriptures. The Bible tell you a man that's forehead bald is clean. Don't right. shave it off or don't shave your head at all. But you can see in Hollywood, you will see all these actors yeah. or upper echelon people, A-class B celebrities, they all shave their head and they beard off. It's an agenda. The white man know, but we don't.
You know what's right. crazy? During slavery time, when the slaves came over here to America, the first thing they did was gave them a Lysol bath and shave their head and beards off.
Damn.
They made sure they did every male like that. It's in that movie, Goodbye Uncle Tom. You need to watch that.
Right.
The whole process.
Now, play number two.
Mike Tyson reveals he suffered near-death experience training for the Jake Paul fight. Lost half my blood.
All right, well, I ain't come here for that. But play the video. Play the video of the post-fight thing. All right, play this point. Now, watch how Jake Paul walk up to him. Now, they walk. This the way in. Play it. Why he crawling up to him like
damn.
That?
Damn.
Why he crawling up to him like that?
Like a gorilla, right?
Right, he was mocking him the whole time. Remember the other video?
Like
he called him an animal. He said, "I want to see that animal." You
and
know,
he showed,
it was other videos.
What he talking about?
Right, it was other videos I seen where he called him animal multiple times in videos. You understand what I'm saying? He's mocking black people with this fight. That's what he did. You understand what I'm saying? It shows that the Negro has a price. When you're not standing in God's integrity, you can be bought. You understand what I'm saying? In this society, when you're not standing on what's right, you don't have the spirit of God in you, you can be bought.
And you know what's crazy? Ain't no black person going to say nothing to Jake Paul about that monkey walk.
That's what I was.
Ain't nobody going to say nothing about it. All those black people there, they should be speaking out against that. Why? Because Jake Paul just insulted us by walking like a damn monkey.
Yep.
A damn gorilla. On live TV. That was the weigh-in, right?
Yeah, that was the
millions
win.
Of people saw that. Man, apes.
When I seen that, because I like a lot of people because I go to the comments. You know what I'm saying? When I be seeing videos, stuff like I go straight to the comments and I'm looking through the comments. All out of all the comments, it was only one person, and you know it'd be thousands of comments in there.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Only one person mentioned that gorilla walk or whatever the case may be. Everybody else was just talking about the slap. Nobody talked about why he slapped him. You know what I'm saying? And ain't nobody addressed the reason why Mike Tyson slapped him. You know what I'm saying? That was crazy.
And they had what? 60? You said it was 60 million? 60 million live.
60 million people.
You live.
60 million.
60 million live is crazy.
On Netflix.
On Netflix. And let me get that in Wisdom of Solomon 15 and 12 real quick.
That lets you know our antennas are down, man. We can't even see that. He did that. Right in front of everybody's face. Nobody peeped it. Go ahead, officer.
Yeah, read that scripture real quick. Because when it comes to our people talking about Denzel and speaking of Mike Tyson, they entertain us. They entertain us. They entertainment. And like you said, they got a price and they can be bought. And this is what the nations, when they demasculate our men, what they do is they set them up as for public humiliation, just like they did back during the time of Rome, back during the time of Greeks. They put us in those coliseums. We was the gladiators. We was the ones they was humiliating, giving these small weapons to fight against lions and bears. That was us. So it's the same thing that happened then is happening now. Read that.
Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 15 and verse 12.
Read.
But they counted our life a pastime.
It said, but they counted our life a pastime. So they taking a 60-year-old man. What a 60-year-old man got any reason doing in a damn boxing ring? Right, fighting a young 20-year-old steroided up white boy. He has no reason being out there.
Damn.
But because our people in such a low estate, nobody sees anything wrong with it because they count our life as a pastime, as a good time to enjoy themselves, Reed.
And our time here, a market for gain.
And a what?
Our time here, a market for gain.
You know how much money they made off of Tyson?
He got 40 million. Tyson only got 20.
Yeah, yeah. Right. So the white boy got 40. Tyson got 20, but what about Netflix?
Oh, man.
What about these other other companies? What about these news networks? What about the stadium? Everybody in the world is profiting off of the disgrace of our people. Yeah. off of the dishonoring and the defaming of our man. But read on.
For say they, we must be getting every way, though it be by evil means.
But though it be by what?
By evil means.
You know what's crazy? Mike Tyson, you know, he's a famous person in our community, right? And I was seeing people like Shaq and Drake, they was betting on Mike Tyson to win. And I'm sitting here like, damn, where is your true friends at? Like, you got a 60-year-old man fighting a 25-year-old. What you go do is place a bet on Mike Tyson. You know what I'm saying? Instead of saying, yo, Mike, that's crazy, bro. Don't do it.
They was probably in on the sham, too.
You right. That's what I'm saying.
Because it was a show. It wasn't a real fight.
Right.
It was an exhibition. You understand what I'm saying? It was an exhibition. It was plenty of people that that done showed that that was an exhibition.
Right.
Mike could have won that fight. But get that in Proverbs 20 real quick. Proverbs 20 and 21. I want to show y'all something about Mike.
Proverbs chapter 20 and verse 21. An inheritance may be gotten hastily at the beginning.
You see that? You can amass a fortune in the beginning fast. That's what happened to Tyson. He was so talented, so gifted. He was knocking people out in 30 seconds. You understand what I'm saying? He made Don King and what was the company he was working for? Don King. He generated over $500 million with his talent, his ability to fight. He did it fast. Go ahead.
But the end thereof shall not be blessed.
You see that? We watching it. Mike Tyson is in his 50s now, late 50s, early 60s, and now he has to lose a fight in a shameful manner. Dude crawling up to him. You understand? Somebody he know he can whoop. Crawling up to him, calling him an animal. You understand what I'm saying? He kissing the man before the fight and showing his buttocks out there.
Damn.
His end is not blessed. You know what I'm saying? The scriptures say we only live in a 70 now anyway. You understand what I'm saying? Any year after that is a bonus. So he damn near deaf. You understand what I'm saying? But look how he going out. Get that in Proverbs 28 and 20.
Proverbs chapter 28 and verse 20. A faithful man shall abound with blessing.
Come on.
But he that maketh haste to be rich shall not be innocent.
If you make haste to be rich, you won't be innocent. What is God saying? Everybody that's rich, they not innocent. You understand? What are we finding out? Ain't we finding that out? Nobody's innocent in Hollywood.
Nobody.
Nobody's innocent. It's all going to come out. Watch what Trump do. We ain't got time to get to Trump today, but watch what he do if he gets in office, if he make it there. We don't know if he going to make it there or not. I think he is, but, you know. But him and Elon going to expose a lot of stuff with all of this. All these entertainers. You understand what I'm saying? Get that in Sirach 9 and 11. Sirach chapter 9 and verse 11. None of these entertainers are innocent. That's why the Lord said we ain't supposed to look up to them. That's why Christ said it's hard for them to get to the kingdom. Because they don't know how. They being covetous. They chasing money. Go ahead, read that.
Sirach chapter 9 and verse 11.
Come on.
Envy not the glory of a sinner.
Read it again.
Envy not the glory of a sinner.
This fight, all black people was up in arms. They wanted to see Mike whoop the white boy. Everybody thought that's what we was finna see. We thought that's what we was gonna see. Why? Because of Mike Tyson history, what's racially been going on the past 5 to 10 years. You understand what I'm saying? Black folks wanted this. Read it again from the top.
Envy not the glory of a sinner.
But guess what? We all forgot that Mike a sinner. Big time. You understand what I'm saying? Go ahead.
For thou knowest not what shall be his end.
We watching Mike end. Shameful. He going out shamefully right now.
Damn.
You understand what I'm saying? With his butt out. Kissing men. Taking ass whoopings by weak, an inferior man.
Bruh.
The basis of man. That's what we watching right now. Go ahead, read.
Delight not in a thing that the ungodly have pleasure in.
You see that? We ain't supposed to have no joy in that. We should have known better than even think that Mike was finna win this fight. The whole entertainment thing is a sham. It's an illusion. It's lies. They all lying to us. Go ahead.
But remember, they shall not go unpunished unto their grave.
You see that? No entertainer will go unpunished. The God said that he will not at all acquit the wicked. Nobody getting away with nothing they doing. You understand what I'm saying? And right now, Tyson, Denzel, they on the last leg of their life, and look how they going out. Look how they going out. Man.
I did post something, so yeah, we can review this real quick. Put that up with Mike Tyson, because he just said Mike Tyson a sinner. That is a true statement.
How do you feel about other people's feelings? You know, you offend a lot of people.
This is show right here, right?
Yep.
He getting hot.
Motherfuckers, homos, and
fags. No, a lot of times I need to shut the fuck up. It's just.
Why don't you?
I don't know, man. It'd be hard.
Why do you say things about person that might be a homosexual? Why do you say that about them? Do you feel the possibility that you're a homosexual and you might disrespect them? You further yourself from being a homosexual or thinking you may like homosexuals?
Nah, I'm straight as an arrow. I'm just saying, you know.
I'm not saying you
are. What's up with your boy Boosie, man? You look a little nervous.
I really commented on the Dwayne Wade situation, yeah. Because I got offended because it's a child. Damn. You know, that's why I really got offended, you know.
That Boosie sound like you finna cry.
And,
he was terrified.
That's why I really said, if it was a motherfucking 19-year-old,
18. They got right. Boosie too, bro.
But look, he kind of trying to do that out of respect of Elder. He look up to Mike Tyson, yeah, like we looked up to Denzel, right, as right, all right, time. Right. So we trying to respect their opinions, because mm-hmm, that's what the Bible tell us to do. Mm-hmm. The Bible teaches us to listen to our elders. That was a thing in a black community. Well, you knew not to disrespect the elders. That was like an unspoken rule. Mm-hmm. If you disrespect the elders, everybody will hate you. People would dislike you. That was an unspoken rule. But you see what Mike Tyson was asking. He said, are you afraid that you might be a homosexual? Mm-hmm. Are you?
That's the talk track that the woke side use. That's they, you know what I'm saying? So it is what it is, man.
Watch this. So that's good. Now, Isaiah 1 and 9. Let's see what the Bible say about that. Because it's every, you look up, tomorrow it's going to be another,
yep,
black male leader pushing homosexuality,
yep,
questioning you about whether you like gay people or not. Like, that's right, an option.
Because you're speaking against it.
Exactly.
Because just because you're speaking against what God's, just because you stating what God said, you homophobic.
Exactly. I think he got a gay daughter, if I'm not mistaken.
Who, Mike?
Mike Tyson. Damn. If I'm not mistaken. And Boosie got a
Boosie
gay daughter.
Boosie got a gay daughter, too.
Yeah, so, I mean, damn, it's hypocrisy.
Yeah.
Lord. If you accept women liking women, then
that's what he, yeah, rap about.
Boosie accept women liking women. He got a,
yeah,
song.
He got a video with two
I
girls.
Like girls who like girls.
Well, that's a hypocrite. Damn.
Hypocrisy.
He was quick to
Babylon,
defend,
man.
Boosie, bro. He was quick to defend Boosie.
Hey, he a hypocrite, bro.
Damn.
Yeah, but yeah, he a hypocrite.
But that's
he like two women in the back seat kissing.
Exactly.
Damn.
Now his daughter
so
got
his daughter
mad.
Just doing what he rap about.
Exactly.
Damn.
I'm just saying.
Isaiah, come on.
Isaiah chapter 1 and verse 9. Except the Lord of hosts had left unto us a very small remnant,
uh-huh,
we would have been as Sodom, and we should have been like unto Gomorrah.
Right. So the small remnant that the Lord left in the earth, believe it or not, it's the Israelites. We the small remnant that God left in the earth, because look at all the men. They submitting to the ideology. If they're not gay, guess what? They're okay with other right, people being right, gay. They got gay acquaintances. You understand? They don't speak out against homo. We all know that's wrong. Why they right, don't speak out against it? Strong men stand up for things like that. If you what they say, silence is a form of agreement.
Yes. Right.
So if you silent, you agree with it. You was about to pull Revelations, unless y'all got some. Revelations 11 and 8.
I was just going to say, that's why you got a bunch of men wearing purses like it's
exactly,
like it's okay. Because look at the leaders, man. Look at the... Ain't nobody standing up against that.
Now put up some images, y'all. Get a bald head or something like that and read. We're going to read Revelations 11 and 8. I just want to show y'all how it go hands... How this go hand in hand. The shaving of the head thing, how it go hand in hand with the Bible. Read this real quick. Revelations 11 and 8. Put up an image or something, y'all. Bald head. Mike, you can put up Mike Tyson bald head or Denzel Washington. Come on, read that.
Revelation chapter 11 and verse 8. And their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city.
Come on, that's talking about the 12 tribes of Israel. That's us. We the dead here. We don't know who we are. This, the great city, is America. Our dead bodies. Come on.
Which spiritually.
Which what?
Which spiritually.
Meaning the spirit or the qualities. Read.
Is called Sodom and Egypt.
Meaning it's not literal Sodom and Egypt. It's a spirit. The spirit, the meaning the customs, the attitude that Sodom had, the attitude or the agenda that Egypt pushed, the Bible say it will be in America. He going to put up Michael Jordan. We could have put up, you know, one of the other brothers. You got the brother shaving his head, wearing his butt out. What is that pushing? Homosexuality. Each bald shaving hair, we all know they go back to Egyptian custom. You see the pharaohs, they all shave their head. But the Bible said it's called Sodom and Egypt, meaning they go hand in hand with one another. These things the white man notice. He put it in his movies in the portrayal. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
Can I get something on that? Hey, get I just posted something in that Telegram. Because you made a good point. You said a lot of people aren't going, a lot of black men, I won't say people, a lot of black men ain't going to stand up and say whether or not that's right or wrong. They not going to say whether if that's wrong. They just going to sit there and be quiet, and they not going to stand up. And that spirit gets put on our people here in America. Because a lot of times you notice younger people be the ones that started the revolutions. They be the ones that be like, man, it's wrong. And he be like, well, why don't the older people, it's not that the older people don't see it. What's keeping them from having that same spirit? Here in America, they didn't beat our people and destroyed our people. Watch this, put that thing up that I sent in there. It's a look, screenshot. So it says, this from a song. It's a rap song, but he acting like he interviewing Tupac. Tupac ain't right either, but he made a good point. It says, all right, well, how long will you, how long will you think it will take before niggas be like, we fighting a war? I'm fighting a war I can't win, and I want to lay it all down. Meaning they going to just put their life on the line. When black people going to say, I'm going to put my life on the line when they see all the evil that's going on? This is what he had to say to them. He said, in this country, a black man only have like 5 years where he can exhibit maximum strength. And that's, he said, and that's right now, while you a teenager, while you still young, while you still want to lift weights, and while you still want to shoot back, meaning you want to fight back against the oppression. He says, because once you turn 30, it's like they take the heart and soul out of a black man. He said, out of a black man in this country, and you don't want to fight no more. Why? Because once that happened, because when you turn about 30, you got responsibilities, bills, things, people you need to take care of. So that go back to what we was talking about with the covetous man. Denzel, he got, you know, hopefully he didn't got some money. But maybe in his mind, you know, a lot of black people say,
he got money.
Generational wealth. I want my kids from generations to never want for nothing. Because that's why Tyson did that. He did that so he can fight. I mean, so he can make money. He did all of those things so that they can make money. They not thinking revolutionary no more. That's how they do our people here. Watch this, though. Read Isaiah 52 verse 23. This the spirit that's been put on our people here. People been rocked to sleep. Don't nobody want to stand up for nothing no more. They done took the heart and soul out of black men. Anytime he want to say a little spark of something right, they destroy him, humiliate him in front of everybody. Read that.
What's the scripture again?
Isaiah 51 and 23.
Isaiah chapter 51 and verse 23.
Uh-huh.
But I will put it into the hand of them that afflict thee.
Read it again.
But I will put it into the hand of them that afflict thee.
The people that destroyed the soul of the black man, the Lord said he going to destroy them. Read.
Which have said to thy soul, bow down.
This is what our people doing. Denzel didn't bow down. Tyson bowing down. Will Smith bowed down. All the black leaders bowed down. Read.
Literally.
That we may go over.
Oh, hold on. He going. He said literally.
Bruh.
That we may go over. And thou hast laid thy body as the ground.
That's how our people are. We become the base things of this earth willingly. Read.
And as the street to them that went over.
Read the next verse. Read.
Awake, awake,
Put on thy strength, O Zion.
That's talking about our people returning back to the Bible. That's the only thing that's going to keep our souls from being destroyed here in America, from them trotting us down, from them taking all the fight and soul we got out of our bodies. You have to come back to this Bible. Denzel, 60 years old, and it's been showing, look, he couldn't die in his quote-unquote integrity. Mike Tyson couldn't die in no integrity. You got to come back to the Bible.
And that's the point, officer. That's why they pushing it. So the Negro don't fight back. They want to emasculate you. They want to, you know what I'm saying? They want you in an effeminate state so you don't fight back. That's what it all comes down to. You know what I'm saying?
Get that in Sirach 14 and verse 9. Sirach chapter 14 and verse 9.
Sirach chapter 14 and verse 9.
Come on.
A covetous man's eye is not satisfied with his portion.
That's what we witnessed with these two brothers. They not satisfied with their portion. They've amassed millions and millions of dollars. They not satisfied with it. Go ahead.
And the iniquity of the wicked.
The who?
And the iniquity of the wicked.
The iniquity of the wicked, read.
Dryeth up his soul.
Guess what? They souls dried up. At their old age, now they just doing anything for a dollar. You understand? Lord's will, they see this and get some type of reproof from it. Get that in Titus chapter 3 and verse 3 real quick. We're going to close it out. Titus chapter 3 and verse 3.
Titus chapter 3. And verse 3.
Come on.
For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish.
So we ain't speaking to our brothers Denzel and Tyson. We upset at the whole situation. But guess what? We was foolish at one time too. Go ahead.
Disobedient.
Uh-huh.
Deceived. Serving diverse lusts.
Doing what?
Serving diverse lusts.
We was serving diverse lusts in our deception. Right now, our people, they don't know God. Denzel don't know God. Tyson don't know God. He's just going after his lust. Read.
And pleasures.
Come on.
Living in malice and envy, hateful and hating one another.
See that? Read.
But after that, the kindness and love of God, our Savior, toward man appeared.
You see that? So the Lord appeared unto us. You understand what I'm saying? Through the scriptures. Go ahead, read.
Not by works of righteousness.
Not because we deserved it. Go ahead.
Which we have done. But according to his mercy, he saved us.
Read.
By the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost.
So guess what? We hoping that our brothers can catch this episode of returning to God so they can repent, keep God's laws, statutes, and commandments. And with that, we say shalom.